and everything, of course, in Chinese here. This is like super unpolished. I'm not even convinced why I should have this. My UI of the system is English. Hey guys, and welcome to Nomadic Mitri channel. So I've got the request to make a review on Tipin OS, and to be honest, I've never heard about this one before. I know that this one is based on basically in Debian with just some additional components, so let's just go ahead and take a look. Alright, so this is what we have. Come on, load. And by the way, the installation wizard has actually warned me about the fact that this is actually running quite slow in the virtual machine. So I'm not expecting a super stellar performance in the virtual machine. And it even like got the option to select like graphical effects to be enabled or disabled. So it basically seems like it's very like graphical intense stuff right here. So let's see how it works. Oh my, it's quite slow in virtual machine plus the screen grab software. So how about we go to the display settings, and yeah, it's very slow. So we should be able to disable the graphical stuff here. So where is it? New system edition available. No, I don't want to update. Come on, I just want to basically disable the stuff here. Disable the effects. Oh yeah, window effect. I'm gonna just disable it right here. Seems like it works better now. Still, it's a bit faster when I'm not screen grabbing, but that's okay. In terms of the UI, it actually looks quite nice. I mean, I like the fact how it looks like. It still feels like a bit strange. For example, let's check the Tipin ID. It says only supported in mainland China is present. Basically, if I press sign in, it seems to be not working in case if I'm not in mainland China. What is that? Okay, so sign up. How about I press the sign up right here? What exactly is it about? Cloud sign up. So what I'm signing up for? What is that? There's no explanation. Where is that? Okay, so it's actually loading the Mozilla Firefox. I think it's Mozilla ESR version, and everything of course in Chinese here. And to switch to English, you need to press right here. Guys, this is not the ideal kind of situation here. It should already know, like by default, if the UI is English, it should actually open this one in English. So which Firefox version we have installed right here? 60.8. Yeah, so the browser is Firefox here. Yeah, I mean, the UI is kind of nice, but still it feels like all these icons are just so huge, and it's kind of like, eh. So how about this? So Text Commander, I installed the file manager here. This is my preference here. I mean, to be honest, it's not my really preference. I just saw this one in this app store. I mean, why do even they call this one as app store? I mean, this is app store is Apple thing, right? It should not be called like that. Of course, we have lots of things here in written in Chinese, and the WeChat is number one right here. So if you want to install it from here, install it. I like the selection of software here. For example, how about we go to the system? Yeah, I like the animations. Animation is kind of nice here. Again, lots of description in Chinese right here. For example, I press here. My UI of the system is English. Why is it even showing anything in Chinese here? It's kind of strange. Please post your comment after sign in. And so I need to sign in here. And the sign up is really only working in the mainland China, as I understand. I already don't like that part. So here, for example, it says multitasking view. And I press on that one. It says, kindly reminder, the application cannot run without window effect. So why does it even show to me here? Like, I don't understand that, guys. So it looks kind of nice, but this is like super unpolished. Control center. So we try here. It's basically showing the same thing what I see in the display settings here. Basically the same thing. Like, why there are like two options? And this Tipin ID, like, I'm not even convinced why I should have this. Default application. This is good. This is actually a really great way to set up those. I like it. Network. Yeah. Okay. Notification sound. Bluetooth. Yeah, it seems to be kind of nice. I also really like the installation wizard. This was kind of helpful. But for some reason, it needed like 70, I think 65 gigabytes of free space available on the hard drive. And for what, basically? There's not much here. I don't know the reason for that. So I'm gonna say, hello, comrades. Oh, actually, it's interesting. Like, if I close this text document, and if I press again, it's just gonna resume this one. Tabbing system is also kind of nice. So if I close it, is it actually just going to resume it like that? Oh no, it just shows like whatever, like what was typed, but not the empty ones. This is actually making sense. I also like the dock right here. It like, I mean, I don't know how it's called. Is it dock? So the calendar app, it looks nice. I mean, all those applications are nice, but I'm not really even sure like what exactly is this app about. Who exactly is the developer of this app? Can we see? Is there any option to see this? Calendar Tipin org. So basically it's their own kind of app they developed for this operating system. The UI is like, some people gonna love it, some people gonna dislike it, I feel. Just a typical terminal here with a typing support and everything, so it's fine for me. What about this? So it actually shows like wired connection, volume. Yeah, I like the UI here. It's kind of nice in terms of setting the volume. And this one is notifications, I guess. Notification center, new system edition available. I don't like the fact that text is basically going here. App store. Yeah, it feels like a ripoff of Mac in many ways. Control center, package cache wipe. Do I really actually need to know that? Update. Okay, I press the update here. Is it any confirmation? Is it actually updating something? Is it updating? So the file manager seems like actually to be nice. So I have the system disk, data disk, and all those. It automatically partitioned all everything, so there was like no problems with this all. The UI is kind of nice. I can just peek this way. Documents downloads, all the typical stuff that you can see in OS. What about music app? So which one is that? It was exactly music, add music. So basically like a music aggregator seems to be something like this. Again, so probably just their own their own app, deepin.org. That's okay. I don't have any problems with that. Pre-select the operation, minimize exit. What else? So auto range icon size, new document. How about this office text? Oh yeah, actually I like this. And the default one is a LibreOffice. This is kind of nice. Yeah, LibreOffice Writer. I mean, it doesn't really fit the UI. Just take a look at those buttons. It doesn't really feel it doesn't feel like it actually belongs to this OS. Quite strange, I don't know. I mean, this doesn't match this UI. No, I don't like this. Yeah, I mean, some apps, as you can see, like not matching this UI at all. How about, what else? Album? This is probably their own development as well, right? So import photos, you can import photos here. Wallpapers, for example, like this one. Import successful. All right, so here it is. And we can like it. Size. Okay, yeah, I can navigate it like that. Nice app here. What about movie? The movie should be like VLC or something, or it's again like their own development here. Yeah. Oh, again, design here is not really polished. Just take a look at this playlist stuff. Ah, yeah, basically it's their own demo like showing up the Deepin OS. So, what else? Screen capture, image viewer, draw. How about draw app? What does it say here? This one should be nice. Like that. I like the UI. So, yeah, guys, I mean, it reminded me during the installation that the performance in the virtual machine is not great, but so far I'm not convinced that I need to install this one anywhere else. Plain text. So it actually opens this one in LibreOffice Writer as well. This is heavy. Okay, how about we delete all those? Add to disk. Okay, we can burn a disk from those, I guess. Does it show anything? So how about we test the empty and trash stuff? Delete, and it's gonna show up in trash. Come on, show up. Are you gonna show anything? Okay, it showed something. And I can adjust the size of the icons here. Stop it, come on. How to end this stuff, actually? Okay, empty the trash. How to close all those? I don't like this, I should say. All right, bootmaker, how about this one? What does it say? Ah, okay, so we can like burn ISO image to a flash drive or a CD drive, I guess, which is great. Cheese, what is it, cheese? What is that? No, don't allow. Okay, this is, I guess, like a camera stuff application here. Now, of course, it's not responding because there is no permission. The application cheese, like terminate. Guys, yes, I want to like terminate. Once again, like why it keeps asking me about termination, like force quit. How about the partition edition? Okay, is it just launching the Gparted? Typical Gparted stuff, nothing interesting here to see. Just all those glancy icons and all that. It looks glancy, but archive manager, what about this one? So what is that? Anything interesting here? No, I guess not. Again, is it actually their own kind of app? Yeah, it's their own kind of app. I mean, so much those kind of specific apps here, those apps pretend to be simple and all that, but I'm still not convinced that I like this. Okay, this one is nice. This one is probably also gonna be their own kind of app. Of course, it's their own app. System monitor. Yeah, this animation is cool. Again, I'm not sure. I mean, this looks nice, but at the same time, okay, is it loading anything? Is it just so slow that it doesn't like show anything? Okay, guys, so this app is still hanging here and it doesn't even like, I'm not able to close this one. I don't really like this kind of UIs. Like, it feels like so simple, like drag everything, but it should actually show me some kind of functionality like right away, like ability to like, I don't know, some menu right here or something. It just feels too simple and I'm not convinced again. Okay, guys, I'm pretty sure I'm not gonna use this operating system full time. I really don't like it. It just feels so strange. It's just so buggy. There are some issues there and there. And if it behaves this way, it's probably gonna be also very, very slow on the computer itself. It feels simple just like from the first look, but at the same time, it seems to me like I'm not convinced that this is like actually the OS I want to use. Let me know in the comments down below what do you think about this operating system. For me, as I said, like I'm not gonna use this one. Please subscribe to my channel if you like my videos and please hit the like button, and I'm gonna shut down this one right now.